I know where I have come from. I know the resiliency within me. I know the willpower that's within me. That's why I enjoy life. I am a proud person. I'm proud of my people. I know what it's like to be dismissed, to be called names, to be treated in a heinous way simply because of your skin color. I know all of that, and I bring all of that into every class I teach, whether the majority of the students are white or black. I don't care. I'm speaking the truth about my life and my experiences. Hi, my name is Eugene Shelton. I am a full professor here in the School of Journalism and Mass Communication at Kent State University. An English teacher suggested that I write for the school paper. It was just about writing in English class, and she suggested that I write for the paper. So I wrote for the Federalist newspaper at Alexander Hamilton Junior High School in Cleveland. And I eventually became editor-in-chief of John F. Kennedy High School newspaper in Cleveland. That was what, and through that work, I received Ed Bang Journalism Scholarship and came to Kent State. And my first job with the press, I was a police reporter. So often I was given assignments or had to cover, talk to police officers, talk to victims' families. Within the year of working for the Cleveland Press, I got a call from WKYC, the NBC affiliate, saying that we would like for you to come down and audition to be the host of a show called Here It Is. Looked at it as being a big fish in a little pond. You know, that I'm on television. I started getting recognized by people in grocery stores and malls and things like this. People, aren't you the guy who hosts Here It Is? And I'm thinking, who's watching Here It Is? It's 6 o'clock on a Saturday. I moved to California. I'm thinking about staying in the newspaper business, but stop being a general assignment reporter and become a pop music critic. And the singer Roberta Flack was the inspiration for that. My interview with Roberta Flack inspired me to think in terms of, I'm moving to Los Angeles without a job. What I'm qualified to do is write. My first job in California, first full-time job, was as a tour guide at Universal Studios. I had a 6-day work week, and the only day that I did not work was Wednesday, and I started freelance writing. The publisher of Soul magazine, Regina Jones, recommended me to Bob Jones at Motown, but he was looking for a full-time publicist. Bob Jones asked me to come in. I did an interview. Next thing you know, I was working at Motown. The first time I worked there, I was there just for 6 months. I started in April. I was laid off by August. And so the director of the publicity staff at CBS flew out to L.A. because he had a job opening. He needed a publicist on the West Coast. I got hired at CBS. I never picked up a phone. I never sent a resume. Every job I had out of Kent, somebody called me, and I just simply said yes. So I worked Earth, Wind & Fire. I worked all the jazz artists, from Bob James, you name it. That was our job, to Herbie Hancock, just to work jazz artists, work all the urban artists. On the big act on the epic side was the Jacksons. Just so many, Patti LaBelle, Teddy Pendergrass, Luther Vandross. So it was just like, I'm in heaven. I love all kind of music. So I had a boss who said, okay. And that's how I got to work with Carl Wilson of the Beach Boys. I'm flying around the country in the Beach Boys' private plane. But he was the nicest man. I lost him. So many artists, like losing Prince today, losing Michael, losing Barry White, losing Curtis Mayfield, losing Carl Wilson. I was a big fan of the Eagles. So in a publicity meeting, I said, I want Randy Meisner. And I got Randy Meisner. One day I got a call from Motown. We want you to come back. I told my boss, I said, Motown is offering me X number of dollars to return. They're offering more money. And I just want to let you know I'm going to take it. And he said, well, hold on. Before you accept the position, let me talk to my boss and the powers that be. So they upped the ante. So I stayed. A year later, Skip Miller, who was head of promotion at Motown, called and said, we need you to come back. Lionel Ritchie's leaving the Commodores. We need you to break him as a solo artist. I want to do this. They're giving me the opportunity to come back and launch Lionel Ritchie's solo career. They want me. So I left CBS and returned to Motown. That was a mistake. But our job was to leave LA, and when you come back, DeBarge better have a number one record. And so I was away from home for more than a month. And we succeeded. That very same DeBarge tour, I was in Chicago, and I'm thinking, when I get back to LA, I'm quitting. I don't want to work at Motown anymore. Motown was very restrictive. Motown was territorial. I had much more freedom at CBS. So I actually quit Motown the second time. I said I'd rather be an independent. I received a phone call from a journalist who said that there is a job opening at Warner Brothers. And I think you should call Bob Merlis, who is the director of publicity, the vice president of publicity, and tell him he would like to interview. I just heard that it's down, the job opening is between you and a guy who is a pop music critic for the Daily News. And he said the problem is that the staff wants him. They know him. They've been pitching stories to him all these years. They don't know you. They know of your reputation, but they don't know you. I was devastated. I actually cried in my dad's arms, and he said, son, if you want that job, you call that man and you go into his office. And I said, why would he want to talk to me if his staff is saying hire the other guy? He said, you won't know until you pick up the phone and call him. And I did. And he said, sure, Gene, come on in. So I did what my dad told me to do. Look him in the eye and tell him that you are the right person for the job. If you hire me today, the work starts being done today. No questions asked. I know how to do it. just too dumb stumbling. The phone rings. It's Bob Merlis. So, Dean, you want it? And I said, well, what? That was probably the greatest day of my life, other than the days my sons were born. No regrets. No regrets. But it was working in the record industry. As much as I love, this job was a perfect segue for my life, my career. I love doing this. I don't feel the pressure of doing this that I felt, because I'm in competition. I want to be the very best at what I'm doing. I want it, when the name comes up, Gene Shelton, people will say he's the best at what he does. So that was my goal, and I think I accomplished that. Career is not everything. Family is always first, but you hit some rough patches here and there. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. You know, I spent 33 wonderful years in a beautiful marriage, and to this day, that my wife is the love of my life. That's why I'm still single. I do believe in divine intervention. I believe that I'm here for a reason. And this was perfect for me, because with all of the experiences that I had in life, and I was always there, and I did game shows. I don't say no to nothing. So these are all experiences that made me who I am. There's no one to let you down. When you got no one, there's no one to let you down. When you got no one, there's no one to let you down.